In order to turn this beautiful hog into this beautiful meat, we need this beautiful machine. Ours just arrived. On back of a big 40-foot long semi-trailer, which made it up the mountain, fortunately, just before mud season. Getting off the trailer was a bit of a trick, because the forks on my tractor are not nearly long enough to take a 10-foot long load. And the load was too wide to go sideways in the trailer. So we did a little bit of a trick using the logging chains. I pulled the load back out of the truck, got it on the tailgate, and then gently, together with the truck operator, we lowered it to the ground. Once on the ground, I raised the front end up, and again, using the chains, dragged the load back until it was off of the tailgate lift. Phew! The hardest part was over. That's a $40,000 piece of stainless steel that I was unloading. It took 8 months to get from Germany. Had I made a mistake and dropped it, I'd have a very expensive piece of scrap metal. Now that it was down on the ground, picking it up with a forklift the other way around wasn't so hard. Just a matter of taking it up the mountain and stowing it away until we need it in probably October, after the abattoir is done in my butcher shop. Will here is checking for me that I have got enough of the spars under the pallet to make sure that I pick up the load rather than destroying the bottom of the pallet. I couldn't see what I was actually doing as I carried this up the mountain, because the hog dehairer is wider than the tractor. In fact, it's longer than the tractor, and it's taller than the tractor, so I couldn't see a thing that was happening on the other side of it. I had Holly and Will and Ben guiding me as I very slowly drove up the What this machine will do is scald the pigs and then take off all the hairs.